Good morning, students. Good morning to everyone. So yesterday, have you remember what we have studied? So yesterday we have studied something about the advantages and the disadvantages of the sole trading business. Have you remember? Okay. Today also we can just remind about the disadvantages of the sole trader. Okay. After that, we can go to the next topic. Before that, we have studied the advantages of sole trading business, right? Some of the easy formation and incentives to work hard and credit standing and personal contact with the customer, small capital and flexibility is all these considered as a advantages of sole trading business. Okay, so if they want to form it or establish any of the sole trading organization, it is easy to establish. Okay, the incentive to work hard mean, so as the level of taking the hard work, he will get some of the reward and more profit. Okay, not only that, so all the earned profit also no need to sharing to their partnership. Okay, he is the only person to enjoying all the incentives. Next, credit standing. Okay, as he has fully liability to conducting their business organization, by having this property, he can able to borrow the money from all the financial institute. Okay, next, personal contact with the customer. So he is the last person to having the direct contact with the customer. So he can easily understand about the taste and preference of the customer and he will be fulfill their satisfaction. Okay, next is small capital. Okay, by having the little amount of the capital also, one man can able to conduct establish the business organizations. Okay, but this facility is only in this sole trading organization. Next, the flexibility. Flexibility means if a individual organizer, entrepreneur want to changing their place or extending their business organization, it is very easy to do. Okay. And also we have studied some of the disadvantages. So one of the disadvantages is limited capital. Okay. So when he has the limited capital, he cannot able to increase their extent of business organizations. Okay. If he want to extend their business organization, only he has to earning more profit. Otherwise, he must increase their capital. Okay. But if he has the limited capital, he can't able to extend their business organizations. Okay, and since the capital is contributed by only individual one, okay, so the limited scales will not helpful to extend their business organization. Next, limited managerial skill. Okay, so in this business organization, single person's intelligence and experience may not help him beyond a certain stage. Okay, so by having their single man's intelligence will be helpful to anyone of the particular line. Okay, even if he has some of the knowledge about anyone of the particular line only, he will get some of the profit. Okay, but one business organization must require all thoroughly knowledge to all the line in their business organizations. Okay, but the lack of the managerial skill or the limited managerial skill, so it is not possible to improve their business. Next, unlimited liability. Unlimited liability means the responsibility. Okay, when he has more responsibility to reason the repay the money to the financial organizations, already they borrowed the money from there. Okay, he only has all the responsibility to bearing the risk of losses. He has unlimited liabilities. Okay, because when he has unlimited liabilities, he has to take all the responsibility to bearing the risk of losses and repay the money to the financial organizations. Okay, next, lack of specialization. So the business unit is small and the financial resources are limited. Experts in different fields cannot be employed to secure maximum advantages. Okay, so normally the people or the individual people have to get the decide to earning the more or maximum advantages. Okay, but if you want to enjoying the maximum advantages, the business organization must be consisting the specialization skill. Okay, or they have to adopting the specializations method. Okay, in this individual persons, individual organization, if it is not possible, means he will not get any specialization and he is not able to secure the maximum advantages. Okay, last one is the hasty decision. Okay, the hasty decisions mean the wrong decisions. Okay, when he has a single persons, sometimes he will take some wrong decisions about their business activities. In this business partnership organization, 5 or more people will be there and the different people will give the different type of the suggestion to solve some of the problems. Okay, but here not like that. The individual persons only have to take all the decision, have to thinking all the idea related to their improving or solving the problem of their business activities. Okay, but sometime this may and his idea may or may not be good or bad. Okay, suppose if it is good, it will be helpful. If it is not good, so it will be lead to loss of the business organization. Okay, so the limited capital, limited managerial skill, unlimited liability, lack of specialization, hasty decision, these 5 are disadvantages in sole trading organizations. Okay, so today we will go to the next chapter. Our next chapter is Hindu Undivided Family and Partnership. So already we have studied the form of business organizations. Okay, in non-corporate industries, one of the classification is Hindu Undivided Family and Partnership organizations. First we will study about the Hindu Undivided Family organization. Okay, so Hindu Undivided Family Organization is a traditional or old method of the business organization. This type of organization is undertaking or controlled by the Hindu law. So before done up the business law, some of the Hindu law was there. Okay, according to the Hindu law only still. So the Hindu Undivided Family Organization is moving or undertaking. And this Hindu Undivided Family Organization does not have any separate and distinct legal entity from that of its members. And not only that, if any of them want to become as a partner in this type of organizations, he must born in their family itself. Otherwise, any of others want to become as a partnership, that guy, that persons must be get married in this family members. Already he is along with the family undivided system. First we will see about the meaning of undivided family, Hindu undivided family. So when two or more families, when two or more families agree to live and work together, invest their resources and labor jointly and share profits or loss together, then this family is known as composite family or Hindu undivided family. Okay, suppose if a families are agree to live and work together and invest their resources and working jointly and share profit or loss together, this is called as a Hindu undivided family. Okay, normally, so any of the joint family belonging in Hindu religious, if they want to conduct any of the business organization, so all the members have to join together and they have to invest all their resources and they have to work also jointly and share their profits together, or if it is loss arised, the loss also have to taking as together. So it is considered as a Hindu undivided family organizations. Okay, this is also one of the traditional method. Okay, one of the joint family is conducting or controlling all the business activities. Okay, so some on the basis of the Hindu law, this type of the organization is carried on. Okay, so what are the characteristics are there in joint Hindu family organization? Okay, so some of the characteristics are there. What are the characteristics are there in this joint Hindu family system means? First, this joint Hindu family system governed by Hindu law. Okay, so this type of organization is controlled and managed under the Hindu law. Hindu law also one of the law is done in the business law. Okay, so Hindu law is also having one of the separate place in this business law, because the Hindu undivided family organization is undertook even from the traditional itself. Next, management. How it is managed? So the, all the affairs of Hindu undivided family are controlled and managed by Karta. Here you have to know who is Karta. So the Karta is the senior most male member of the family. Okay, normally, who is the senior member in this giant family? He is considered as a Karta. Karta means, so he is the premier one. He is the leader of that family. Okay, so all other family, all the members of other, all others members of this family have to depending upon their activities. Okay, so maybe as a grandfather, as union of the father, maybe act like a Karta. So the members of the family have full faith and confidence in Karta, even if he see if he has taken any of the decisions related to their business organizations. If they going to make a contact with the another persons, and if they extend their business organization, reduce the organizations, everything also is taken only by that Karta. And all other members have to faith and confidence in Karta. Okay, so only Karta is entitled to deal with the outsiders. Because whatever things he want to do, he can do without asking the permission of all other members. Okay, but all other members must get the permission to the Karta. So anyway, this management, all affairs of this undivided family is controlled and managed by Karta. Karta means who is the leader of or most senior male member is considered as a Karta. Next, membership by birth. Okay, how one person became as a membership in this business organization mean? As I told already, so the membership of a family can be acquired only by birth. As soon as the child is born in the family, that child becomes a member. So membership requires no consent or agreement. Okay, so without any consent and the agreement, so the born baby also will have the power to become as a membership in this business organizations. Okay, otherwise any of the female have to get married of the male members already he has belonged in the Hindu undivided family. Okay, otherwise no persons cannot be able to become as a members. Okay, but in this members maybe the male or female or maybe the minor. Next, liability. So except the Karta, the liability of all other members is limited, but the Karta only has unlimited liability. Okay, because as he has more power to making the all decision related to their business organization or having the deal with the others, he only has the unlimited liability. Okay, because he only has more power to dissolve the organizations. Okay, so even all the members are not having the consent to dissolving the organization, he has right to conduct. Okay, so except the Karta, so all the other members have the limited liabilities, and the Karta only has the unlimited liability. Okay, even if the other members are not having the money, so the borrower or the financial organizations will not recover the money from that other members. Okay, but the money lender or the financial organizer or the borrower can recovering the property from the Karta only, because he has able to recovering all the properties from the Karta. Next, permanent existence. So no factor will not affect the existence of Hindu undivided family of organization. Okay, so no factor means, so the death of one members or death of the Karta or death of the lunacy or the insolvency of the members, everything will not be bringing the form of organization to end. Okay, even if any of member is dead or became lunacy, or if the organization is come to an insolvency, means all other members or only one member also can able to continue this business organization. Okay, for example, in a Hindu undivided family organization, the 10 members are there, and the 9 members are died, means so the remaining 1 persons also can continue the organizations in the name of these persons. Okay, so no factor will be affected the existence of Hindu undivided family. Okay, even 1 persons can doing the business as continuity. Next, implied authority of Karta. Implied authority means, so the separate power or the separate entity of the Karta. So in this Hindu undivided family organization, Karta only has the implied authorities. That is, he only has the full right to make the dealing with the other business organization or other third persons. Okay, so all other members will not having or will not making the dealing with the other or the third persons. Next, minor also co-partner. Co-partner is the meaning is, so partner. Okay, in this Hindu undivided family organization, even the minor or even a newborn baby can become as a partner. Okay, suppose if any of the baby is born in the same family, so the born, even the newborn baby also became as a partner. Okay, even if he has willing or non-willing, he can able to become as a partner. And another one of the things, the minor doesn't have any right to make in any agreement. Next, dissolutions. Dissolutions mean dismantle of the organization. It is possible only the will of all the members. Okay, if the business organizations want to come to an end, so the all the members have to provide the consent. Okay, so willingness of all the members, in the name of willingness of all the members only, this type of organization will come to an end. Otherwise, it will not come to an end, even if there is one person does not having the interest or willing to dissolution of the firm. Okay, the remaining persons can continue the organizations. Okay, so any single member has no right to get the business dissolved. Okay, so all the members have to get the willingness to dissolve the organizations like a partnership. Okay, then what are the characteristics are there? First one is the governed by law. Okay, so this type of the management is governed by law. And the management, so the full all the management, all the affairs of this Hindu undivided family is undertaking under the name of Karta. Karta means, so who is the most senior male member is considered as a Karta. Next, membership by birth. If any of the persons want to become as a membership in this organization, only by the birth he can easily become as a membership. Next, liability. Who has the liability? Mean except the karta, all other members has the limited liability, but the karta only has the unlimited liability. If it is any loss, so the karta only have to take all the responsibility. Next, permanent existence. Okay, by the reason of death or lunacy or insolvency of the firm, so this organization will not come to an end. Okay, next, implied authority of karta. Implied authority means the separate power of the karta. So the karta only has the special right or the separate right to making the deals with the another persons. Next, minor also co-partner. Okay, even a newborn baby can become as a partnership. Okay, but he does not have the rights to make the or put the signature in this agreement. Next, dissolutions, the dissolvency. Okay, so it is possible only with the all members, will of the all the members. If there is no willingness in even one member, so this organization will not come to an end. Okay, students, next, the partnership organizations. So already we have studied, you know, so the different type of the organization is there. First, sole proprietorship. Next, Hindu undivided family organization. Next one is the partnership organizations. Okay, so the partnership form of organization is an extension of the sole proprietorship. Okay, by the single persons, different, if there is a different type of the task and the problem was there, so the single persons want to having some of the benefit by joining some of their friends or other persons. So as already been explained that the sole proprietor form of organization suffer from several drawbacks such as limited capital, limited managerial ability and concentrated risk and less chances for expansion and growth. So it is considered the partnership organization. When a sole trader finds it difficult to handle the problem of growth and expansion, he takes a partner. Thus, it represents the next stage in the evolution of business organizations. Okay, so one of the evolution of the sole proprietor is as a partnership organization. So normally the meaning of partnership is the relation between persons who have agreed to share the profits of a business carried out by all or any of them acting for all. Okay, if one persons are joining some other persons together and the all the persons are agreed to share the profits and working together and carried on their business by all or any of them acting for all. Any of them acting for all means sometimes the single persons have to organize the partnership, but all other partnership may be in the name of nominal. Okay, by the namely only some of the persons will be acting as a partners. Okay, but all other partners, any of the single persons will doing all business activities. So here also some of the characteristics are there. So one of the first characteristics of partnership is contractual relationship. Contractual relationship means, so the partnership is the result of an agreement. Okay, so before when they are come to put the signature in this agreement, has to explain or has to understand all the rules and regulations of the partnership. Okay, so after considering, after accepting the all rules and regulations, norms and conditions only, so the, all the partners will come to an agreement. Okay, and when the agreement may be oral or written. Okay, but it is not a compulsory, but if the agreement is made by written, so it is benefit for all other members. So consequently, persons not competent to contract. consequently patients mean, so maybe the problematic persons, so we will consider as a minor. Okay, so in this agreed partnership organization, so the minor partner will not come to an agreement for this partnership organization, because the minor partner will not have the rights to put the signature in the agreement. Okay, so on the basis of the contractual relationship only we can make a partnership organization. Okay student, remaining we will study tomorrow. So in this Hindu undivided family organization, if you have any doubt, please ask me, and just to study that same portions, the characteristics of joint Hindu family organization. Thank you.